My name is Timothy Brock. I'm a specialist in music for cinema, particularly live cinema, silent cinema from the 1900s up to the advent of sound in 1926. I've been conducting orchestras in front of a screen for almost 40 years. And I also serve as the music director for the Charlie Chaplin family, which is what brings me to Toulouse, and I'm very happy to be here. When I was 10 years old, I saw my first silent film, and it was at the Granada Theater in West Seattle, USA, and I was just taken by it. I've never seen anything like it, and there's this giant Wurlitzer came up from the ground and started playing with this enormous sounds, with his enormous pipes, and playing these things I've never seen before. And I saw Nosferatu, Cops, and Steamboat Bill Jr. in the same day. And I was so excited, I came home to my mom and I said, "Mom, I want to do that. I want to do what that guy does. I want to make music for old films, old movies," I said. And she's been worried about my career ever since then. In 1998, I got a call from the Chaplin family. And they wanted to know if I would be interested in doing Chaplin's Modern Times. So 2 weeks later, they flew me out to Paris from Seattle, and they showed me five boxes that had not been opened since the 1930s, and said, "It's in there." I thought, you know, it's all these boxes. I thought, how could the score be so big? But it was all the boxes and all the parts for Modern Times. So I spent a week in Paris looking at it and said that this would be great, it's almost complete. And then they bought out my contract, which I had with the Los Angeles Chamber Orchestra as air conductor, to go and work for them. And subsequently I've been working for the family and have restored 13 of his film scores and made four or five adaptations of other film scores as well. And right now I'm in the middle of restoring the score to The Great Dictator for live performance. One of the greatest things about doing live cinema, of course, especially for those who've never seen it, is that you have an entire orchestra, a symphony orchestra, in front of a screen playing live to the screen. And the connection that an audience member gets with the images on the screen is just that much more supported, that emotional tie, when you have live musicians. And you just get so wrapped up into it, especially the Gold Rush, because the Gold Rush people get, I don't want to, there's no spoiler alerts here, but the ending is a nail biter. And so when things jump or jolt, you can hear people gasp and jump and stuff. And it's quite amazing. And it has this great quality. It just brings the people really into the screen directly. Of course, my job is difficult because I have to keep the music in synchronization. The film runs at 24 frames per second. And I have about 6 frames a second leeway to be correct, because when Charlie wrote this music, he did such a thorough job, as he always does with all his film scores, that having sound effects and dialogue, like in the modern day, is completely superfluous, because you don't need that at all, because the music has the dialogue, has the motion, has sound effects, it's got everything. But you gotta have a conductor who knows the film well enough to get it all in sync. A lot of audience members don't kind of forget the musicians are there because it's just so together. But the orchestra has to watch me. If they're not watching me, then we fall straight on our backs. But but this orchestra is doing really well. I'm really, really pleased with the orchestra here, because they're just, they want to get it right, and we're having great time.